Welcome to the video, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Early this morning, woke up about 5:30, and had a couple hours of the deepest insight that I've ever experienced, and it was really quite remarkable. And concepts kind of don't hold together too well. I can talk about it, but the context has to be very clear, or else people will think it's too much. I mean, the context was very clear for me, so I was able to see what I saw and agree with it and say, yeah, I see this is very true. But to try to just talk about it without any context to somebody, they just think you're absolutely, gone off the deep end. But, I don't feel any sense of that whatsoever. Just the opposite. I feel like I'm just in very shallow water. There's no problem. nothing concerning at all. And then later on today, more insights of just an incredible nature that, again, if I were to share that, I think some people would absolutely go nuts over it. I think what people are scared of is not, they project their own fear of going nuts over what they hear onto the speaker and saying, the speaker must be crazy. What they really mean is, oh my gosh, if I hear this, I'm going to go crazy. My whole world is going to be, I'm going to realize that it's not as, not the way that I think it is, etc. So that's why you need a spiritual path of maturity. You need to mature. So I was able to get to look at stuff in a very mature way. And what I saw was just so remarkable. And simple. But the insights are there, I'm telling you. Don't think that you have, gotten all the way and you know it. No way. The teachers in the world, I'm always looking. There's some that touch upon it, but it's still shallow, what they were saying. Maybe because it's quite difficult, really, to, if you're not really spiritually mature, it's very difficult to see this. You're not going to be able to see it. Because it's kind of, this existence is crazy. I'll tell you the truth, it's existence that's crazy. But there is, that which we are is not part of existence at all. At all. We are not alive. What we are is not alive. Has nothing to do with life or aliveness as we define it at all. What we are is eternally present. We are eternally present. We've never been born. We've never died. We cannot become alive. Therefore, we can't be killed. We can't die. We cannot die. Everything that dies has absolutely nothing to do with what we are. Complete scam, sham. I call it a training exercise. The purpose is to train us, try to teach us how to die. We cannot. How can that which never has been born, how can it never die? I saw that everybody that comes to see the guru really comes to kill the guru. That is true. It is actually true. They want to say, they say, I just gotta, if I can just figure out how to kill the guru, because everyone's trying to kill themselves, but they've never been born. No one's ever been born. The guru's never been born. The gurus want to just realize they've never been born, so how can you kill the guru? There is no guru. The guru is the one who realizes there is no guru. The guru's never been born. That is true. The guru function, there's a guru function, but there is no guru. What the guru function does is it makes certain bodies who agree to it, there's a sort of agreement of an aspect of spirit, say, okay, this body that I've been trying to use to teach myself how to die, I will allow the guru function to use it to attract other aspects of spirit to the guru function. And then people call that body the guru. But no, there's no guru there. There's a guru function that is making that body very attractive in a spiritual way. The body becomes, the persona, whatever, the present, the person here seems very attractive in a spiritual way. But people think they're interacting with the guru. They're not. They're they're being helped by the guru function, as it were. Call it the Holy Spirit, the guru function, the Holy Spirit, same thing. But there is no guru. There's never been a guru. So you can't kill the guru. When people say they want to kill the guru, what I mean is they want a guru to be there. They say, you know, where is the guru so I can kill the guru? So, you know, they think that the guru is someone that has finally been able to be born. So then they can finally kill the guru and everyone can then figure out, okay, we figured out how to die. So we can now be prime creators, replace God. There is no such thing as birth or death. And we have never been born, we've never died. There is no guru. There's nobody to kill. And so what happens is people go to kill the guru and they realize there is no guru to kill. And then it's like it blows their mind. And that's what blows their mind, actually. They say, it's just like the real guru blows people's minds that way, but the real quote-unquote guru who's not there, there is no guru, but the guru function through a body blows people's mind in that way. They go away like, what happened? And nobody knows what happened. I don't know what happened, but something happened. I just don't know what it is. Well, what it is you failed to kill the guru. You failed to kill the guru because there is no guru. And it's like the ego, everything is just like, what happened? What happened? What happened? I don't know what happened. Something happened. I don't get it. So, it's just like, wow. Wow, something is just really extraordinary. I'm not sure what's going on. And the guru function showed me that this early this morning. Showed me what it's all about. So for aspects of spirit that think they've been born, they need to think that there is some guru there. But there isn't. So when they go to see the guru, they want to say, okay, where is the guru? I want to kill the guru to prove that the guru has actually been born, you know, into vulnerability, etc. Nothing is ever born into vulnerability. There is no birth, so to speak. We talk about birth meaning birth into flesh, vulnerability, impermanence. No such thing. Being is eternally present. So when we turn our attention to the part of the mind that's aware of this, then everything's easy because there's no more birth, no more death, no more, there's never been any. I've never been born, you realize, I've never been born, I've never been here. None of this has anything to do with me at all. I'm not there at all. I've never been there. Never will be there. So it's not, you know, there's nothing there to die. There's none of me there to die at all. I'm not somewhere. You know, I'm eternally present. It's very different than being, quote unquote, alive, all this life we claim. No, what we are is eternally present. So you might just say, I am eternally present, and just sort of let that sink in. What does it mean? I don't know. But it's pointing to a fact, and facts are already facts, so you don't have to make them a fact. So you're just sort of reminding me there's this fact. I'm eternally present. I am eternally present. I am the eternal presence. Nothing to do with life or aliveness. Nothing to do with it. I am the eternal presence. So we need, this is necessary. The guru function needs to function now because people are hurting. People are in trouble. I'm telling you, it is not a joke. I've taken it so seriously because I don't know. I get the feeling from some, it's just, hey, life's pretty good. I got a nice degree, nice job, savings, and I go to satsang and try to say, okay, you know, everything's pretty good with the world. Oh, sure, yeah. I don't know. Everything's not okay. There's desperate struggles going on in people's lives right now. Desperate struggles. and people are getting crushed. The world is crushing what we think we are. But you see, we believe that, again, that the impossible is possible, so we just call it difficult. So people are enmeshed in this extreme difficulty of trying to become alive, and they're failing at it, you know. And it's horrible, horrible for them. It is horrible for them. I've been there. I know exactly what it's like. So I really, you know, just have no patience for those who are not really pushing, just pushing all the way. And you've got to realize that no one's ever been born. That you have to realize that. To be helpful at this time. Otherwise, you're just, you know, having a frat party or something. I mean, really. Having a kegger or something, really. I mean, just, what's the difference? Let's talk about, you know, some spirituality. Same thing as a frat keg party. Same thing. No difference. So we are attempting to accomplish the impossible, which is to kill ourselves, kill what we are, kill eternal presence. And then we're trying to give birth to eternal presence, trying to give birth to a life that get eternal presence to be born. Cannot. Eternal presence cannot be born. But we're struggling to do so, and we're locked into this incredible difficulty, and there's so much deceit and manipulation. I mean, it is so sickening, really. The dance of existence is so sickening. It is so repulsive when you see it. It is so wicked. It is just unbelievable. I mean, what I saw today, of the lengths that we go to continue to deceive ourselves, it is just, astonishing. We used to think in terms of like individual relationships, how people can be very deceptive, how someone can mess up real bad, and then they can find a way to frame someone else and make them seem that they're the one that messed up, you know, and make themselves look all lily white and pure and innocent, kind of stuff. Some people are always able to come out, make themselves look innocent, and put all the blame on others when it's their own actual refusal to take responsibility for their own failures, etc. But what you see is this happens on a global scale. It happens on a cosmic scale. And there are these psychic archetypes that exploit this and always come out smelling like a rose, like they haven't done anything wrong, yet they're the ones that have been messing everything up, so to speak, teaching falsehoods, etc. And then they create a big global disturbance, and then they are able to distract everybody, and then they're able to make themselves seem to be the innocent, harmed, victimized party, and then they go on and set up another situation just like the one before that teaches falsehood, etc. And this just goes on a global cosmic scale. Yeah, it's just the deception's on a cosmic scale, actually. And you see it, and it's just like, good Lord, you know, how boring. It is so repulsive. It's boring. Again, very boring, really. The larger the scale, the more it just hits you like, this is really sad. I mean, this is just pathetic. What we're doing, trying to do. Trying to be prime creator. This whole soap opera is really pathetic. The bigger you see it on a bigger and bigger scale, that's when you start realizing, my gosh, how pathetic. And then you lose interest in it, you know. It's just ridiculous. The lengths that we are trying to go to, they're just ridiculous. If it's just this personal dramas and stuff, we say, oh, okay, that's no big deal. But when you see the lengths that we go to deceive ourselves, then it becomes a farcical, really. It really becomes farcical. So, I mean, people's nerves are on edge right now. And having spent a lifetime with my nerves on edge, I know, all too well what that's all about in every way. And just a couple nights ago, my entire nervous system was chaotic. I mean, chaotic. And I said, you know what? If I don't pull it together right now, I'm going to absolutely lose it. I'm going to die or perish, you know, as it were. my nerves, my body cannot handle this. And I had to make a great effort of will to center myself and say, no, I'm going to continue on. I'm going to stay centered. It took everything I had to. So people are coming unglued. They're becoming unglued. Good people. I mean, you know, not some kind of horrible, wicked criminals or something. No, very conscientious good people are coming unglued now because there's a massive effort to pin all the blame on all the screw-ups in the world, on scapegoat a group of people, so the rest can feel all innocent and pure and continue on in their delusions, etc., thinking that oh, this now we got it right. We got rid of all the bad guys, you know, that kind of thing. It's a deadly game that's taking place in this world. Ruthless, so ruthless, you know, it just very unwelcome, to say the least. Merciless and ruthless, and the ones that's come out all pure and innocent, pretending that, you know, they never lied, cheat, distorted, introduced false teachings, twisted things, you know, in other words, function according to the ego. No, it was all those other bad guys that did that, and you know, they're perfect, you know. It's just the opposite. So there's enormous projection taking place, an enormous pressure to crush reason, to crush those who want to reason stuff out, to crush them. Just completely wipe them out and die of stress, really. And that's not a good thing. Not a good thing at all. Not happy about that. So the guru function is necessary at this time, very necessary. To just, the guru function informs you. You've never been born. No one's ever been born. No one's ever been born. It's either easy to get this or it's impossible to get it. One of the two. It's either easy or impossible. And you either get it now or you get it never. You either get it now or you get it never. Because if you don't get it now, when are you going to get it? Tomorrow never comes. It's always now. So you either get it now or you get it never. And it's either you get it easy or you don't get it at all. And that's a fact. You either get it easy or you don't get it at all. So in my videos, I've tried to bring to light, you know, what's going on in the world. I try to help people realize that it is not easy times now. In fact, just the opposite. It's brutal. It's really brutal. Severe brutality in the world at deep all sorts of levels, from all directions. We're getting it from all directions right now, as a matter of fact. And you know, even what I'd say some of the better known gurus I saw in a dream last night are not there. They're not there. Which is why we're not feeling it. We're not feeling it. Where is that function that knows it's never been born? Knows it. Absolutely. There's no question whatsoever. It absolutely knows that it's never been born, never can be born. And where is that? I don't want all this conceptual stuff. You know, it doesn't do any good. Now when people are really, really getting crushed, you have to have knowing. Knowing has to be there. Not slick, non-dual talk. You know, knowing has to be there. And so that's the real guru. That's the guru function. The guru function is a knowing. Effortless knowing. Easy knowing. No difficulty. No difficulty in this knowing whatsoever. None. No. This guru functioning has to be functioning here. Nobody's willing to let their bodies, you know, function that way. Nobody's willing to do it. those that are willing to do it need to, you know, come to the attention of people. Come to the attention. Because all you need is that knowing, that sense of knowing. And that gives you a new point of view. Gives you a new point of view. Right now, the point of view that we have, it's killing people, as it were. People, yeah, people can be killed, of course. It's just crushing the nervous system, killing people. This a brutal regime in this world now. If you're not cutthroat, you know, you're going to be crushed. And so this knowing gives a different point of view. It's not a conceptual, it's a knowing. It's an ease of knowing, the ease of knowing. The effortless ease of knowing. That immediately we say, wow, there's a different viewpoint. I'm not stuck. I have an option. What I'm getting from people right now is saying, yeah, it's terrible. Isn't it awful? But what are we going to do? We don't have any options. It's just the way it is. That is the worst thing. To say that. That's what the ego wants everyone to believe. There's no option. There's no guru function. How can anyone say there's no option? Are they completely unaware the guru function can function here in this world and give a different point of view, an ease of knowing. And the knowing is that I'm not here. I've never been born. I can never be born. I know this. That's the realization. I'm not here as this life and aliveness and all this stuff is nothing. It's nothing. Nothing at all. And it has nothing to do with what I am, eternal presence. Absolutely nothing to do with it. It's like a cartoon. A whimsical, farcical cartoon that is just ridiculous and has no meaning whatsoever. And it's the ease of knowing this, an ease of knowing. What we need is this ease of knowing. And this ease of knowing can be talk about anything at all. Talk about this baseball game or something, or whatever, weather, it doesn't matter. They know they're not here, they know nobody's here. So it's like nobody talking to nobody, but there's a knowing that nobody is here. There is no here here, actually. There is no here here. Impermanence. What is impermanence? It's nothing. So that the ease of knowing is what we feel. The words don't mean anything, actually. It's the ease of knowing is something that is recognized, or some kind of inner recognition. That there's a different viewpoint here, and that is what gets our attention. And then we start saying, what is this other, what is this difficulty? You know, there's an ease of knowing and there's this difficulty of not knowing. And you say, wow, there's two different viewpoints here. I wonder which one is I want. Options, you see. What's crushing people is they don't see any option. You know, I don't think it's right. I just don't think it's right. So I keep trying to do something about it. Having been crushed myself and having been through it, I know there's no mercy there. There's no mercy. I found no mercy except a different viewpoint. That's the only mercy I found. But within the ego, there is no mercy. None. It claims it's all merciful. It's not. All the while it's telling you how merciful it is, it's crushing you. So, you know, trying to prove to you that you can die. That's what the ego is doing. It's trying to prove to you that you can die. How fun is that? It's not fun. The ego keeps saying, here's the proof. I got the proof right here. Look how terrible you're suffering. I got more proof. It keeps piling proof on you. Yeah. So that's no fun. Completely bogus, all of it. So, the ease of knowing this is all completely bogus, etc. That is what everybody needs. Everybody needs it. And the sooner we admit it, the better off we are. And I don't care what they're talking about. Really, it doesn't really matter at all. It's just someone saying, it's okay. You're not here. I'm not here. There's nobody here. There's never been anybody here. You've never been born. It's okay. It's okay that you've never been born. It's okay. Nobody's ever been born. Nobody ever will be born. We're unbornable. We cannot be born. What we are cannot be born. It's impossible. And that's okay. Just that, just reassure. It's okay. It's all right. That, less the clouds. That's like a lighthouse in the fog. And the fog now is hitting the ground so hard, people can't see where they are. It's very distressing. It's ruinously distressing. So I call upon the guru function, to be active here, to be very active here at this time. Because that's the only, remedy we have. It's the only remedy we have, actually, is this effortless knowing, this ease of knowing that what we are can never be born. So how'd I do? Did okay to kind of convey, this is a sense of the insight that I was getting this morning. And there's more actually. I saw more of the dynamics of how this guru function can function in the world, and how people treat the guru, actually, guru function, the body, very nicely, because in a funny way, they feel sorry for it. They feel very sorry, and it's like a sportsman who's hunting big game or something, and like bighorn sheep or something, and they're climbing up and down cliffs and mountains, and they're chasing, and it's like, wow, unbelievably difficult thing, But it's the thrill of this challenge and the chase to bag the bighorn sheep. But what if the bighorn sheep wanders into your living room and sits down on your carpet, and smiles at you, says, "Hi, right? Hi, I'm here." The sportsman's gonna say, spit on it, and say, "What are you doing here? I don't want you, my friend, hanging. I want you running through the cliffs and Mount Rocky crags, and I want to be chasing you for a week. I want to go through this grueling ordeal to bag you." So they don't want some retarded, crippled bighorn sheep that comes up and says, "Hey, I love you so much. You're my friend. I want to just hang out with you." So they say, "Oh my gosh, terrible sheep. I feel so sorry. Well, this is awful. This is awful. Here, let me help you out. Let me help you out so you can once again run through the mountains and I can chase you." So the guru function is seen in this world as like a retarded cripple, as it were. And people end up being very generous to the guru principle, because they want the guru principle to be more of a elusive quarry, so they can hunt it down. That's really what's going on. That's really what takes place. It's a funny reverse psychology. Like I said, the people have their dignity here, so to speak, and they're not going to shoot fish in a barrel. There's no sport in that. They want it to be sporting contest, and there's no sport in, going trying to kill that guru, because the guru is too easy. It's too easy. It's too easy. So they say, "Come on, guru, make it a little more difficult for me. Come on." There's all sorts of like crazy, reverse psychology, upside down, backwards stuff that is just, really, it's just the way that it is. I mean, this is the existence. The whole thing is very strange, actually. It's really, it doesn't have a good taste to it. Existence doesn't have a good taste to it at all. So for those who want to chase, they want someone to run fast so they can chase fast. And the guru's just sitting there, and they go, "Come on, guru, can't you run a little bit? Can't I chase you a little bit? Come on, come on." The guru says, "No, I've never been born. How can you chase what's never been born?" They say, "Oh, come on, can't you just at least imagine that you've been born? So I can chase an imaginary you, imaginary me chasing imaginary you. Can't you play the game?" Guru says, No, the guru function is its purpose is to inform us truthfully." Yeah, so people are very deflated about that. They come away very disappointed in the guru, very disappointed. But then they think, what can I do to get that? Why? It's so sad. But it obsesses them, people get obsessed. They just have to like figure out what's going on here. How can I heal this guru function thing that's just not, is no challenge to me, no challenge at all. The ego wants a challenge. It says, I'm out to kill God, I mean, then this guru's too easy. It's not helping me. It's not helping me. Not helping me at all. Oh, very funny stuff. The psychology of the ego is just bizarre, It's just, But it is what it is. And it can be effortlessly seen for what it is. And it plays many games and tries to reverse things and upside down and just not what you think is going on here in the world. It's not what anybody really sees at all. Crazy game that's being played. An imaginary me is chasing the imaginary you, and imaginary you is chasing the imaginary me. Everyone's hunting each other, and trying to bring about, the demise of spirit, of eternal presence. So there can be a new creation and a new creation, new creator, new prime creator. All to no avail at all to no avail. And the teachers that there are those who see like this vastness of this game and everything that's going on, and just like, wow, okay, just notice everything, and that's enlightenment. It's not, even enlightenment's a hallucination. I mean, it's they don't recognize it's a hallucination. It's not reality, it's a hallucination. Even, seeing, quote unquote, seeing the presence and everything, that's an hallucination too. But it corrects the continuity problem, corrects it. Solves it, solves the continuity problem. And there's one thing that they're missing. I've noticed that there's some that have recognized there is nothing, there is no thing, there's just this one vast, they call it life or something, but it's not, it's a dream. So when they see one dream, this vast dream, they think that's reality. It's not reality. And then they see the eternal presence. It's still, they're seeing, still seeing a dream. It's still a dream and a hallucination. It's still imagination, but it's corrective. It's corrective. But it's a mistake to say that it's reality. It's not. It's not. So they're coming up a little short. They're coming up a little short. A little short. And that's what I've noticed, that the teachers come up a little bit short. Just they can't quite get the full wide panoramic context of the situation and how it's really a continuity problem that's being solved. It's really a continuity problem, that's all. But if you see everything as just one thing, then how could it be born? It just is. There's no birth to it at all. So, there is that realization to it, definitely. So I'll keep an open mind. I've got an open mind to the various teachers. I do have an open mind. I'm just showing my perspective here also and contrasting it, as it were. But yeah, if there's only one thing, what could it be born into? if there's nothing else, just this one vast presence, isness, what do you want to call it? But even though it's still things, but it's just all one thing that we're seeing, perceiving. What does it get born into, if that's all there is? What does all there is get born into? So this is another way of looking at it. How can you cannot? You cannot say it's born into itself. Itself, what do you mean? Is there two selves? No, there's not two selves. There's just one self. How can the one self be born then? What gives birth to it? Born into what? It's not possible. It's not possible. So it seems like some have gone that direction and they're trying to accept this, that there's only just everything that is everything that is. There isn't something else other than that. Therefore, there is no real possibility of being born into something else. You know, there is no real, there's no birth. They're able to, somehow they're on that trail, you know, they're on that trail. But I'd like to see more bliss. I'd like to see more ease. The teachers that I've seen are, you know, just, I'd like to see more of the ease of knowing, ease of knowing. You know, shining through the bliss, shining through the ease of knowing, the guru function, shining through. I'd like to see more of it, that's all. We need more of it. We need more of it. For everybody, I really believe this, that everybody on the planet needs to make a concerted effort, okay, to go in this direction. The ease of knowing. To pivot from the area of the mind that's concerned with this difficulty, which is really impossibility. Pivot to the area of the mind that's involved with ease, which is really effortless facts. Presence of being, the eternal presence of being that is unborn, can never be born into anything because it's everything there is. It's the allness. Can't be born into anything. Cannot be born. So another way of saying it is everything we're seeing is actually unborn. Nothing is ever born. This is kind of a mystical insight that some have get a glimpse of it. Nothing's ever been born. Not even impermanence. Impermanence has never even happened. Nothing has ever happened. So, again, the ease of knowing this is what we're after. Now, conceptually, we can get there, but we need the ease of knowing. The ease of knowing is the only thing that gets us to really adopt a new viewpoint. And from that viewpoint, there isn't any depression. There isn't any problems like that. There aren't any problems. There's no existential problems at all because there is no existential. There is no out there. There is no out there and in here. There's no dichotomy. There's no duality. So all of the psychology of duality doesn't apply anymore at all. And if you realize it never applied. So the ease of knowing this is what we're after. So, you know, I'm just praying that we come across those who have this ease of knowing and we put them up there and say, hey, please, just sit, let us feel that ease of knowing right now. You don't have to jump through hoops for us, you know, just sit. Let us just sit there and let us just feel this, you know, that's all. Well, put them in a stadium, put a million people, let just people come and just sit there and be quiet and just feel the ease of this knowing. Whatever, do it, in, you know, wherever you are, in a house, wherever, just sit down and that's needed. It's needed as an emergency right now. And it's not business as usual. It never is in here, but right now it is a full-blown emergency. And it's going to get worse. The dream that I had, maybe it's almost like 10 years ago, about what's going to happen specifically in certain specific events, they're happening exactly as I was shown, which has got me very concerned, because there's going to be a huge push towards re-education. There's a certain faction that is very irate right now that we didn't jump into war. Very irate. And they feel that the president has let them down and betrayed them, and they're furious, actually. And that's what I was shown in the dream. Exactly what's taking place is there'd be a push for deadly strikes, and then there'd be a backing away from it. It wouldn't happen. And this causes the power behind the throne to be infuriated with the president is just a salesman, to tell you the truth. He's just a salesman. That's all he is. Very slick, super salesman, but that's all he is. He's selling an agenda. He's not setting it. There's a power behind the throne that is setting the agenda. He's just selling it. He's just a salesman that plays golf, basically. You know, I mean, that's what salesmen do, right? They sell, and then they go out and play golf. That's all that's happening. He couldn't sell this. He couldn't sell it. And they're furious with him. So there's going to be a re-education campaign that's going to take place, and that is big trouble. And there's also someone coming along who's going to exploit this crisis for their purposes and make themselves look great. That is coming too, in my opinion. We'll see how that plays out. So it is just a terrible time, because this re-education, it is, you know, worse worse than a deadly strike or something. I mean, it really tries to get you so locked in and confused. And so people are feeling on their nervous systems, they're feeling this pressure that is here in the world. There's enormous pressure in the world right now, and they're feeling it, and they just can't take it. They don't know what to do with this pressure, you know. So again, you need a different viewpoint. Yet you have to abandon lies. You cannot nurture lies into truth. You have to abandon them. You have to abandon the impossible. You cannot succeed at it and then set it down. No, you have to set it down unsuccessfully. You say, this, I did not succeed, and I must set this unsuccess down. It's impossible. You must set it down. You must set the lie down. In other words, you must have a new viewpoint. You must have a new viewpoint. And then start practicing looking at everything from the new viewpoint and saying, hey, you know, this is, from this perspective, nothing's wrong, because there's nothing here, as it were. There isn't anything. Nothing's ever been born. So how can anything die? How can anything suffer? There's no suffering, there's no birth, there's no death. There's a, you know, it's a different viewpoint that is just like, solves the inner, you know, storm. Inner storm is calmed from that. So that is what we need. And we need it right now. It's like now or never. Now, it's now or never. Always. So, all right. I got, you know, got to move on, and but not too fast. Just stay in this moment of the importance of it. Not lose sight that this is all important in people's lives. All important. Because we'll just have to start using coping mechanisms for the pressure. And that makes things worse. Makes things worse. And as we fall apart, the younger people who could still handle the pressure just end up crushing the older people. For sure, it's hitting the older people very badly, I'm telling you. And it's very ruthless what's happening. And the younger people, their nerves can handle it better. They can go along for a while. They can go along with it. Not all of them. Some of them are getting crushed too. What's happening in the world is ruthless. So guru function has to step in. I said it would step in. We'll see. We will see if that takes place. All right. Very great. Keep your options open. There is another viewpoint. There is another viewpoint. And you can view it from that viewpoint. You can. You can pivot to that viewpoint. It with a little encouragement. Okay? That's great. That's it.